In this video, you'll learn about all functions and the sound of the top-tier Fabfilter Timeless3 Delay plugin. Hi, I'm Marlon. Timeless3 is the latest version of this delay plugin. In true Fabfilter fashion, the interface shows exactly what you are hearing and is very clear to use. The plugin allows for simple usage for quick results. But also allows to dive in deep and go down a rabbit hole with the modulation section. More on that later. You can clearly see the settings you set for the delay and feedback control on the left. You have a syncable delay. And you can set the delay time for both channels individually. And of course, this is the feedback dial. I always like to EQ my delays to have them sit better in the mix. On the right side, Timeless3 has a built-in EQ section which works like Fabfilter's Pro-Q3. If you have ever worked with that plugin, this will be a breeze. The basic two filters have an analog sound to them which can't saturate. The characteristics of these can be changed. Besides these two, you can also add clean sounding frequency points with a range of EQ types. Here's the all-important mix control to dial in the amount of delay you want. And you can set the stereo width from mono to fully stereo. Of course, this only works on a stereo track. Ducking will duck the delay when a dry signal plays, which helps keeping things clear. And instability will warp the feedback delay, which adds movement. Timeless3 has 5 delay effects, as in you can change how the delay sounds. You enable the effect by pressing here for every effect. The first effect is drive, which will saturate the delay the more you crank it up. Make sure you also set the input volume to saturate even more. Lo-fi speaks for itself. It will apply bit crushing and sample dividing. Fortunately, it's modeled to leave out the high frequency ringing you can get with bit crushing. Diffuse is nice, it will add diffusion which will get you into reverb territory. This is very nice when you want to have the delay less defined. At low settings, it softens the transients, and at high settings, it really is like a reverb. The dynamics work the same way as with, for instance, the Fabfilter Saturn 2 plugin. To the left, it will work like an expander and gate. and to the right, it will compress and get into pumping territory. The pitch is also great. It will apply pitch shifting to your delay. Now the plugin has some advanced controls. Let's stick with the pitch shift we just did. On the top left, you have the pitched shift mirroring, which will flip the pitch shift for the right channel. In small amounts, this can be used as a thickening effect on, for instance, vocals. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. 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 On the top right, you can choose if the pitch will be inside or outside the feedback loop. Outside means that all tabs of the feedback loop get pitch shift with the same amount. Inside the feedback loop means that every new tab of the feedback, so every new delay, will pitch shift the previous tab. So it will increasingly pitch up or pitch down more and more. Moving over to the delay dial, there are some advanced controls as well. Changing the slider on top will offset the left or right channel. This will instantly make the delay broader sounding in stereo. Pressing here will set the delay into a few ping pong delay modes. The freeze button will stop the feed of the original sound. But only keeps repeating the first sound that came in endlessly. This button here will change how the sound will change when you change the delay time. Normally it's tape style. So there will be some pitch shifting and change of speed when you change the delay times. And you can change it to stretch. So it will use time stretching when you change the delay speeds. The feedback dial also has a slider on top, and with this you can set where you want to pan the feedback more. To the left? Or more to the right channel? And you can set how much feedback of one channel will feed into the other. Talking about channels, Timeless 3 can do mono, standard left-right stereo, but also mid-side, which opens up very interesting delay sounds. feedback controls the number of repeats, or taps as they are called. By pressing here in the tap window, you can see you can choose from a bunch of presets which will alter the behavior of these taps. Let me go back to default. By hovering here, you can see this plus sign. If you tap on it, a tap repeat is added. You can move these to wherever you want. You can adjust the volume. And by pressing Ctrl or Command, you can change the panning as well. Now, the real rabbit hole is when you take a peek again here below. This section is the modulation section, which has 6 modulation sources which come with their own presets. Like as with Fabfilter Saturn 2, these modulators can be used to modulate a whole bunch of targets in the effects, primary delay settings, and the EQ. This opens up a whole new world of creativity, sound design, and adding interest to the delays. Let me show you with a few examples. The plugin truly is a one-stop from simple delays to creative sound design. But how does this plugin compare to top-selling delay plugins? Check out the video displayed on screen to find out. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video, and I will see you in the next one.